In this lesson, we will discuss the theory of conducting modeling studies. In prior videos, we discussed how to create pie groups for the purpose of studying a system experimentally in an easier and more efficient manner. One example that we've covered extensively is how to find an expression for the pressure drop per length of pipe, delta PL, for a system where there is steady, incompressible, isothermal, fully developed turbulent flow through a smooth-walled pipe. We deduce that delta PL is some function of the flow speed V, pipe diameter D, fluid density rho, and the fluid's absolute viscosity mu. Using dimensional analysis, we found that two pi groups are required. The pi 1 group is delta PL D over V squared rho, and this is some function phi of the Reynolds number. We also discussed how to conduct an experiment where we vary the Reynolds number by varying the flow speed, measuring the pressure drop over a test section of pipe, and then performing a curve fit on the data that gave us the function phi is equal to 0.15 times the Reynolds number to the negative 0.25. Finally, we can solve for delta PL, which is equal to 0.15 rho v squared over d times the Reynolds number to the negative 0.25 power. If there are a small number of variables, such as in this situation where we have 5 variables, you usually can find the desired functional relationship between the dependent variable and the independent variables using dimensional analysis and a few experiments. However, many systems have numerous variables that impact the dependent variable. For example, if we want to find an equation to predict the drag on a large building, which we'll call FD, the flow speed V, fluid density rho, and the fluid's absolute viscosity mu should impact drag. The shape of the building will impact drag as well, and in order to describe the building's shape, we likely will need to specify dozens of different lengths, and each of these lengths are variables which would have to be included in the equation for predicting drag. If there are dozens of variables, dimensional analysis will yield dozens of pi terms, and this means we would need to conduct many, many experiments to get a general equation for drag for a building. This could be quite cost prohibitive. A common method used by engineers to get around this problem is to study the behavior of models. A model is a representation of a real system, which is called a prototype. The behavior of the model is used to predict how the prototype will behave under specific conditions. A model is usually significantly smaller than the prototype. This makes them easier to handle and much cheaper to construct than a full-size prototype. But how can we ensure the results from experiments conducted on a model will accurately predict the behavior of the prototype? We can answer that question by examining the following fictional scenario. Let's say there are two engineers who are studying the same problem but working completely independently of each other. They're both trying to find an expression for the pressure drop per length of pipe for a smooth-walled pipe that is experiencing steady, incompressible, isothermal, fully developed, turbulent flow. The first engineer is studying this problem using the system on the left, which we'll call A, and the second engineer is studying this problem using the system on the right, which we'll call B. Both engineers correctly deduce that delta PL is some unknown function of the flow speed V, pipe diameter D, fluid density rho, and the fluid's absolute viscosity mu. We'll use a subscript A for these variables in system A and a subscript B for these variables in system B. Both engineers perform dimensional analysis and realize that two pi groups are required to study this system experimentally and find that a valid set of pi groups are delta PL D over rho V squared and the Reynolds number, rho V D over mu. To find the relationship phi, both engineers conduct experiments where they vary the Reynolds number of the flow and find that phi is 0.15 times the Reynolds number to the negative 0.25 power. Let's bring the two equations to the top of the screen and continue. Now let's say both engineers happen to run their experiments at the same Reynolds number. That is, the value of pi 2 is the same in both systems. Since the functional relationship between the pi groups phi is the same for both systems, this means that the pi 1 terms are equal to each other as well. Rearranging the equation of pi 1a equals pi 1b, we have that delta PLA equals rho A over rho B times dB over dA times VA squared over VB squared times delta PLB. This equation leads to a powerful realization. If engineer A knows the diameter of both pipes, the density of both fluids, and the speed of both flows, engineer A can simply take engineer B's measurement of the pressure drop per length of pipe in system B and use that result to predict the pressure drop per length of pipe in system A. In other words, engineer A does not have to run any experiments at all. We can make predictions about how system A will behave at a specific Reynolds number if we operate system B at the same Reynolds number. For example, let's say the diameter of pipe A is 3 times larger than the diameter of pipe B. The absolute viscosity of fluid A is twice as large as the absolute viscosity of fluid B, and the density of fluid A is 1/2 the value of the density of fluid B. Perhaps the engineers are using the same fluid at different temperatures and pressures, or using different fluids entirely. Now let's assume that we want to predict how system A will behave at a Reynolds number of 10,000. We can operate system B at a Reynolds number of 10,000 and measure delta PL for system B. Since the Reynolds number of system A is equal to the Reynolds number of system B, rho A VA dA over mu A is equal to rho B VB dB over mu B. Plugging in the values for dA, mu A, and rho A, and performing some algebra, we find that VB equals 3/4 of VA. This means if system B were operated at the same Reynolds number as system A, the flow speed in pipe B must be 3/4 the flow speed in pipe A. We now return to our equation relating the pressure drop per length in both pipes obtained on the previous slide. The ratio of rho A to rho B is 1/2, the ratio of dB to dA is 1/3, and the ratio of VA to VB is 4/3. So the pressure drop per length in pipe A would be a factor of 8 over 27 smaller than the pressure drop per length in pipe B. If engineer A wants to predict the pressure drop per length in pipe A, when the flow is at a Reynolds number of 10,000, engineer A can simply ask engineer B to operate pipe B at a Reynolds number of 10,000, measure the pressure drop per length in pipe B, then multiply that value by 8 over 27. Engineer A does not even need to build pipe A in order to make predictions about how it would behave. We remove the labels A and B on the two systems and replace them with labels P and M, which stands for prototype and model. Now let's restate everything we've learned thus far using these new labels. The dependent variable, delta PL, for both the prototype and model is a function of the same independent variables. Using dimensional analysis, we find that 2 pi groups are required to study this problem experimentally. Pi 1 is equal to some function phi of pi 2. Since the dependent variable in both systems is a function of the same independent variables, we should expect that the function phi of the prototype and model are the same. And finally, we can predict how a prototype should behave at a particular value of pi 2 by running an experiment with the model at the same value of pi 2. If we do that, pi 1 of the prototype should equal pi 1 of the model, and we can develop an equation for the dependent variable of the prototype in terms of the dependent variable of the model. Now let's generalize this concept for systems that have more than 2 pi groups. In general, a system will have n minus k pi groups, where n is the number of relevant independent and dependent variables, and k is the number of reference dimensions required to describe those variables dimensionally. If we want to predict how a prototype should behave at particular values of pi 2, pi 3, and so on, we can operate the model at the same values of those pi groups. That is, pi 2 of the model equals pi 2 of the prototype, pi 3 of the model equals pi 3 of the prototype, and so on. We call these the similarity requirements. If the similarity requirements are met, then pi 1 of the prototype should equal pi 1 of the model. We call this the prediction equation, and it's used to find the dependent variable of interest in the prototype, such as the pressure drop per length of pipe.